Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. This video series will show you some digital beauty retouching techniques. In the previous video, we degrained our image to create a clean plate to work with. This video will focus on isolated spot removal using masks and pixel spread. If you would like to follow along, please click the link in the YouTube description to download the media. If you are watching the podcast version of this video, then type the link displayed in your internet browser. Now we all have spots, freckles, beauty marks, and all of those things build up the characteristics of our face. However, sometimes in TV and movie world, this is a definite no-no, and it's our job to clean it up. So let's start with this spot right here. Hover over the Connect Effects node bin and press G for the G-Masks node. Drag out the node and connect the output of the degrained CFX clip to the G-Mask node. Let's rename this node to Spot Mask. Double-click the G-Mask node to see its controls and click on the Result Viewer to activate the masking tools. Press F1 so that we can draw on the front view. Click Add and draw a small shape around the marked area. The shape does not need to be massive, but just enough to contain the spot. Scrubbing the time bar, you can see that the mask is correctly positioned for the first frame, but then Matt begins to smile. So we need to track the mask to his face. Go over to the mask transformation controls and click the stabilizer button to enter into the tracking tools for object tracking. Let's zoom into the image to work with the finer detail. On the first frame, place the tracker boxes over the mark we want to eliminate. Click Analyze to start the track. If you encounter a problem in the track, stop the track when you can. Scrub the time bar to the last good frame. Click Snap to set the current frame as the new reference pattern. Press Analyze to pick up the track from this point. If the tracker goes off again, just stop the track, snap it to the reference, and analyze again. Eventually, this should get the track. This technique is very useful when tracking a pattern that changes shape over time. If you are satisfied with your track, press the Return button to exit the stabilizer. Scrubbing the time bar, the mask should be tracked to the face. If there are multiple areas you want to treat at the same time, just draw multiple masks and track them each separately. Now that we have isolated the mark, let's remove it. Select the viewer and press F4 to return to the result view, and you will see the mat for the mark. Click the Effects Node button for the Connect Effects node bin. There are multiple ways of cleaning up images, like painting for instance. However, pixel spread does a fabulous job cleaning up small marks. Hover over the node bin and press P for pixel spread. Drag the pixel spread node into the schematic. Rename the pixel spread node to spot removal. Now connect the output of the degrained image as the red front input and green background input of the node. Connect the output of the G-Mask node as the blue matte input. So the mask will limit the region of the pixel spread. Double-click on the pixel spread node for its controls. We want the spread type to stretch the pixels. We also want the spread mode to contract into the mask and not expand outwards. So increasing the stretch amount, you can see that the mark is slowly shrinking until nothing is there. To smooth out this area a bit more, increase the spread blur until you're happy with the blend. Just by scrubbing through the time bar, you can see that the mark is removed. Just go to different frames and toggle the bypass button on and off to verify that it works properly for you. So you can have multiple masks inside the G-Mask node, and one pixel spread node will fill in all the targeted marks. In the next video, we apply skin smoothing and line removal. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.